look like was bothering, but how did the knee feel after that missing the game yesterday?
Oh, it's good. It's good. Just getting, you know, comfortable. Like I said, I was a little sore yesterday. Felt more comfortable today.
You had the two runs, I think it was 14 points in about 3 minutes in the second quarter, and then 8 points in about a minute and 7 seconds in the second half. What are you feeling offensively when that's going? Just the rhythm, the way the ball feels off the hand, what stands out to you when you get in that kind of a zone?
Just like you said, the rhythm. For me, just playing the right way and letting the game kind of come to me, and it allows me to find that rhythm. Also, my teammates, they draw a lot of attention, so it allows me to attack the third and fourth, you know, best defender. So I'm cool with that. But as far as what I'm feeling and things like that, I feel nothing. I'm not really thinking about anything. You just kind of mention flow state a few times, just kind of get there and finding ways to get there.
D'Angelo, if I have the numbers right, you guys are 11-6 in the 17 games that you've played since coming back from the tailbone. What level of ownership do you feel with that success for the team, and what level of responsibility do you feel to continue to play at this level so this team can reach its ultimate goal?
Honestly, there's no thought, there's no extra will, there's no none of that. I've just kind of found a pocket that, you know, I can reach my flow state around these guys, you know, within the game. So when I'm out there, I'm not thinking about anything. I'm not thinking about score 20 points consecutively in 12 games and all that extra. I really just play, and these are the results.
Damn. Now I'm gonna look that up, that stat. But we just got one from the Lakers that the last time starting lineup for this franchise all scored 20 points was 1984. What does that say about kind of, I mean, one, obviously the night that you guys had, but what kind of drove it? It felt like the passing was really important tonight. And just kind of where are you guys at in that part of the game?
Well, we have 30 assists, 7 turnovers, something like that. I think, you know, any talented group, you know, when you share that ball, it's so much it's just a gravitational like movement for your best players. AD, LeBron, the gravity is just forced to go with them and allows guys to attack on the backside. You saw Rui, you saw Austin, you saw myself. You know, and when we share it, the ball finds the right place. This might be too soon, but I give Nikola Jokic a lot of credit. Just the way he plays. You know, one of the most unselfish superstars we've ever seen. You can see around their team, you know, everybody's dangerous. Everybody's playing off of, you know, his gravity. And I think that's the way the league's going. You know, a lot of the best players are, you know, becoming more passive and sacrificing to win, because it's a tough league to win in. When I first got in the league, I just remember it being easy to dominate the game, but now it's harder to win. I feel like, you know, teams are scheming well, coaches are better. I feel like schemes are better, defense is harder. You play guys so many times throughout the year that you kind of get that familiarity with what they're trying to do, schemes, things like that. So you have to pass it. You have to be unselfish. Opens up the game.
You mentioned the passing. I think over the last 15 or 16 games, you guys are either number one or number two in assists. Is that just a reflection of not just being unselfish, but the chemistry being there, the chemistry being present within the units now?
You could say that. I think we're still figuring it out. Still trying to get guys healthy. We saw Vando come in and change our whole dynamic. We saw Cam Reddish go through a spell where he was changing our whole dynamic. TP, now Rui's being that guy. I think just the with all the guys that we have, it's gonna allow guys to step up when their names is called, and guys did a good job. So I think the chemistry is definitely growing. Trade deadline just ended, some guys a little more comfortable. So I think it's only gonna get better from here.
Theo, obviously, one key thing I see is coming from a back-to-back here that you guys played, and you brought in that energy offensively, especially in that second quarter. But you guys collectively just were successful with it. What stands out to that? Because that's usually a rarity when it's a back-to-back.
Yesterday we lost to Dallas. I mean, not Dallas, Denver. Close game. I think we kind of let that one get away from us. I thought we had a chance, real good chance. And they made plays. They won the game, but we felt that. I feel like going into this game that we let that one kind of slip away. I think we had a chance and we didn't take advantage of it. So for tonight, obviously I came back with that energy, but I still think guys were, you know, still trying to get that one back. You know, individual pride, just me being a little spark kind of just made it easier, I guess. But I like where we're at. I like our team.
Kobe.
We saw Rob with Spencer Dinwiddie. Obviously, he's a free agent. You were teammates with him in Brooklyn. Just what is he like as a person? Just what could he add to this team if he decides to join?
I'm a fan, but y'all get to know him soon. We'll let y'all dig into that and give y'all any titles or anything like that.
D'Angelo, Jonathan Williams with Views, but in the days that we've honored Kobe in Los Angeles and as someone who got to play with him, what does it mean to you and this team to get a win in front of the thousands who came to celebrate this team on and Kobe on this day?
Huge. Yesterday, obviously, I wanted to play and be a part of this movement and give the fans what they were, you know, begging to see, just get the win for him. It brought me chills, to be honest. I was talking to one of our security guards that was around when he was around, and to hear the crowd chant Kobe like that, it was pretty surreal for me, and it gave me chills. Just haven't heard that since the last game, and to get that feeling back was, and not be here was kind of different. So definitely want to get the win for him and for our fans as well.
Last question.
D'Lo, we talked to you in Charlotte before the trade deadline, and you acknowledge that because of your contract that there's a chance you might be traded. Obviously you weren't. What's your mindset kind of going into the second half of the season?
Nothing changes.
What's your emotions at the deadline staying here?
Emotionless still.
Thanks,
Bob.
Yeah.
AD said something yesterday. I like the trade deadline and kind of wear on people, and sometimes it gets in guys' heads and stuff like that. You saw D'Lo tonight, Rui. It seemed like everybody played with yourself, like with a lot of freedom around the Stars. What did it feel like tonight in terms of kind of the flow you guys were able to hit offensively? And I don't know, just, you know, if you can speak to sort of the rhythm D'Lo got into at a couple of different points too.
Yeah, I mean, I think it was just a testament to, you know, playing the game the right way. We were making the extra pass. We were getting wide open looks, to be honest. And, you know, when D'Lo sees a couple go in, I mean, I got about a 97% guess rate correct when he's about to shoot it, I can tell you every time. And, you know, I love it. It's a beautiful thing to see. You know, you cheer for guys like that, you know, are good people. And I think, like I said, it just comes down to us playing the game the right way. And, you know, like you said, Rui was huge tonight, too. I feel like we just played with, you know, force. And then we were really decisive on top of that.
Okay.
Is there anything else in your life where you're right 97% of the time?
Absolutely. Well, if you ask me, yes. But if you ask anybody around me, no.
You guys, I think, are like 20th in the league in offense or thereabouts. You scored 51 points in the second quarter, which ties a franchise record. I know the numbers are what they are, but something like that, is that evidence that this group is capable of more than how you're performing?
Yeah, for sure. I think, you know, as you see tonight, when we get in a good rhythm, a good flow, you know, we have so many options and we have like so many ways to attack defenses because of the skill set that we have on the court. You know, still somewhat new, but we're continuing to grow and build that chemistry on the court and feel more comfortable playing alongside one another. But tonight was you.
Okay.
97% of the time it's on me.
But I think that just shows what, you know, we can do as a team offensively, and you know, we could obviously clean some things up defensively, but
Austin, continuing with the offensive theme, all five starters had at least 20 points tonight, and this group's only, I think this was the third game you guys have started, you know, over the last few, but what are you seeing in terms of a rhythm and just kind of how the offense is flowing with you five specifically together, and just all five guys can score from basically anywhere on the floor?
Yeah, I think we played this lineup quite a bit last year, end of the year, a little bit into the playoffs, so we have kind of a good feel, you know, how to play with one another. And Rui gives you somebody that can, you know, shoot the ball, but as well, if you put a small on him, he can go straight to the post and operate out of there. And, you know, he made a couple really good passes tonight that was very inspiring. And, you know, obviously AD and Bron doing what they do, and D'Lo as well. But we're just looking to continue to grow that together and continue to get better.
Cool. Austin, you guys lead the league, at least over the last 15 games, in assists. How much has that been a discussion over the past couple of weeks? Or has it really been a discussion the past couple of weeks, that specifically?
No, I don't think so. I think it's just, once again, playing the game the right way. I mean, you look at, you know, the stat sheet tonight, you know, Bron and AD only took, or Bron took 13 shots, AD took 11. Bron had 14 assists, AD had 6, and, you know, AD didn't play but 29 minutes because of foul trouble. But I think, like I said, it's just playing the game the right way, because when we do that, I think everybody gets a better feel and gets in a better rhythm and settles into the game a little better.
Thanks, Austin. Coaches, appreciate you guys.
Darvin, we've seen the offense mostly just be on uptick for the last couple of weeks. Tonight, obviously, it was a, you know, went beyond that. What did you see that just led to that, and how did it flow out of that first quarter?
Just the ball movement. We highlighted it in our pregame film. Something we've been talking about a ton. Just, you know, passing on time on target. I'll back up, like, the pace, spacing, our running habits, starting there. Getting good screens to create an advantage, and then passing ball, attacking downhill, making sure the ball touches the paint. And then once we get in the paint, pass on time on target. The defense usually tells you where the ball should go. And then just guys being shot ready and shot aggressive.
Russell kind of typified that. I think he had 14 points in about 3 minutes in the second quarter, and then he had 8 more in a minute, or about a minute and 7 seconds in the second half.
Yeah.
How do you see him develop, and when he gets like that, and do you feel like that's been more consistent, even if not nuclear like that, but it's been building?
I mean, just all of us, you know, encouraging him to be decisive and deliberate and aggressive. As I've been mentioning, I think I mentioned it before this game, you know, those stretches, we needed all of that. You know, I told him he saved our ass a little bit in his own humble way. You know, he, you know, credited his teammates as well. And everybody stepped up and had a big game. I don't know when you had a starting five here the last time, 20 plus points each guy, but, you know, he spearheaded that. Just his energy, his shot aggressiveness. All of that was on point, and his teammates were looking for him, and you know, I give freedom. And so some of the walk-ups, and once he has it going, him, Bron has his stretches, and AR, AD, whoever, Rui, you know, we try to find those guys, and we encourage those guys to stay aggressive, and that definitely was the case with D'Lo tonight.
Yeah. Darvin, I have two quick ones for you. First, on D'Lo, I think you guys are now 11-6 in the last 17 games he's played.
11.
Oh, no.
You hear that, Dan?
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's good.
Bring that one up again. Just
put that up there with irregardless.
At some point, though, he was, he was not as consistent, not as reliable. At any point in this stretch, did you or anyone from the team kind of reach out to him and let him know, like, hey,
what you're doing, like we need moving forward. And when yesterday came and went, was that, do you think there was a peace of mind that he knew that he would have a part of this team moving forward?
Yeah, man, you know, I think a lot of times people will think you're full of ish when you're telling them we have enough in the locker room, we just need to get healthy and get whole. The way he's been playing, you know, the way he started off the year, and, you know, he hit a little tough patch, and you know, every NBA player goes through that, especially when you're scoring this league. You're going to hit a drought every now and again. But, you know, to his credit, he kept working on his game, kept working through it. And I know I've encouraged him, you know, to stay aggressive, be aggressive, asking him ways I can help, you know, him orchestrate what's going on out there. You know, he's calling stuff, going play calling back and forth between Bron, him, myself, Phil Handy, AR. We're all just trying to make sure we stay organized. And, you know, I give him the freedom. He'll look at me, give me the thumbs up, you know, let me know he's got some a play planned out already. There's a dead ball, someone shooting a free throw. So just giving him that freedom and constantly myself, the staff, his teammates, encouraging him to stay aggressive. I think he's in a great place, and he's a worker. And so the work he's putting in, I saw him just, you know, he didn't sulk. He didn't, you know, implode when he was struggling a little bit. You know, he just got in the gym before practice, after practice, before shoot around, after shoot around, just really working with Coach Michael Fraction, putting in a lot of great work. And you know, asking all the right questions and film and whatnot. It's, you can see, you know, he just buckled down and started leaning back on his work and not felt sorry for himself.
We saw Rob with...
Not feel sorry for himself, I should say.
We saw Rob with Spencer Dinwiddie sitting together at the game. We saw Spencer outside the locker room. Did you have a chance to speak to Spencer at all? And if so, what was the message?
I just smell some great brisket back there in our food room.
Did he cater?
Maybe. I think he brought the sauce.
Darvin, you mentioned the five starters all having 20 plus points. That's rare, but does that kind of show the offensive ceiling with that group when you decided to put them together for the New York game? And just what have you seen over these last few games from that unit together and just how they're gelling offensively?
I mean, each and every guy being able to get a defensive rebound and push it, it helps our pace. Each and every guy is able to score from all three levels. That helps our attack. We got three guys in there, even D'Lo. Four guys that can post up. Everybody can play pick and roll. You know, as a handler or as a screener. It's just the versatility offensively, the explosiveness offensively puts a lot of pressure on our opponent. And everybody's competing defensively. You know, help communicating, talking, helping one another. You know, obviously, two areas that, you know, we really want to clean up and try to be consistently good at is our defensive rebounding and not turning the ball over. And that's something we challenged that group with and the entirety of the team. But just the explosiveness of that group, you know, it trumps a lot of different things. It's like a power five, and they all gel and play well off each other. It's going well, really well.
Last one, Dan.
Darvin, really quickly, Max was going to meet with people today. We saw him walk out. It looked like he was moving pretty good. Did you guys get any further update on Max's condition?
Probably when I get out of here, I will. I'm sure there'll be some official update tomorrow morning for you guys to read and have.
You guys have, in LeBron and AD, two really, really good scorers, two of the best in the league. But their skills as passers, particularly during the stretch, particularly tonight. How important is that for this group offensively moving forwards, just them as distributors, and would you like to continue to see them focus on that part of the game?
Absolutely. You know, that's just who they are, man, trying to play the game the right way. it's anything you can do, I can do better type of deal. Like, you know, D'Lo had 14 assists in Boston. I'm just looking, Bron had 14 assists tonight. But that just they love playmaking. You know, they get probably more joy out of playmaking and throwing a nice dime as they do scoring the ball. And I'm sure all of them will tell you that. But just that's another thing that this group brings is high level IQ, high level understanding of where you're supposed to be spaced at, what the defense is doing, what schemes the defense are throwing at us, whether heavy shifts or all out double team or two and a half guys, a double team with another half guy in the middle of the paint. They definitely know how to make their reads, both Brian and AD and all five, D'Lo, Austin, Rui as well. So, and we move, you know, the guys know when you're sharing the ball, they know where, when and where to be in the right spot. So it's just, it's beautiful basketball to watch when it's moving like that.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.